In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of shoulder muscles. In first part, I am going to explain anterior part. In second part, I will explain posterior part. Let's get started. First muscle is this huge muscle. This is pectoralis major. Pectoralis major, also known as pec major. This is very big muscle on anterior part of shoulder. Main function of pec major is flexion, internal rotation, and adduction. Flexion is you raise arm upward, internal rotation is this way, and adduction is you close arm this way. This is very powerful muscles. The next one is this one. This muscle is very unique. Its shape is like triangle. Thus, this is deltoid. There are so many functions that deltoid can do. I will explain three functions. The main function is abduction. Abduction and flexion. Flexion, you raise arm up. Then the other way, extension. Abduction, flexion, and extension. Of course, deltoid can do other movements, but that's a lot of movement that in this video. So I'm explaining general function. This is also strong shoulder muscle. Pec major and deltoid. Let's go to deep layer of anterior part. Deltoid and pec major are removed. Let's get started with this one. This is biceps brachii. Biceps brachii, that's weird, because main function of biceps brachii is elbow flexion. Yep, this muscle can move elbow very strongly. However, if you focus on attachment of biceps brachii, this guy attaches to scapula. That means biceps brachii crosses shoulder joint. Thus, this can move shoulder. I will explain three movements. Main movement is flexion. Flexion of shoulder joint. This is very important muscle for shoulder flexion. Then internal rotation. It's very slight movement. It can't move shoulder a lot, but it can do internal rotation. And slight adduction. Main function for shoulder is flexion. Other two movements are kind of minor movement. However, it's important to know biceps can move shoulder. And deep to biceps, there's one more muscle here. You see that? This one. This is coracobrachialis. Coracobrachialis. This muscle attaches to coracoid process and humerus. Thus, this is coracobrachialis. Functions of coracobrachialis is similar to biceps brachii. It can do flexion. Flexion, slight internal rotation. And adduction. Main movement is flexion, so it's like biceps brachii. Internal rotation and adduction are minor movement. Biceps and coracobrachialis are very similar. The last one from this picture is this one. This is on anterior part of scapula. This is subscapularis. subscapularis. This is part of rotator cuff. It can do only one movement, that is internal rotation. Internal rotation. This is very important for stabilization of shoulder as well. Of course, it can move shoulder joint. However, it is equally important for stability. Very important. Well, these are anterior shoulder muscles. Let's go to posterior part. Okay, these are posterior shoulder muscles. Kind of a lot, right? I will start from these two muscles. This big one is latissimus dorsi. Huge muscle on backside. Then this one is teres major. Teres major. Why am I talking about these two muscles together? Because functions of these two muscles are identical. Let's see. These two muscles can do extension. Extension of shoulder. Internal rotation. And adduction. These two muscles can do identical movement. See, easy enough, right? Then let's go to three rotator cuff muscles. Let me explain two muscles first. This one and this one. This tiny one is teres minor. Teres minor. This broad one is infraspinatus. Teres minor and infraspinatus. Function of these two muscles is also identical. That's external rotation. External rotation. Actually, there are three muscles that can do external rotation. That are teres minor, infraspinatus, and deltoid. I didn't explain external rotation for first part, but you know, deltoid also can do external rotation. That's not a lot of muscles. Many other muscles can do internal rotation, but external rotators are very less. It's good to know. The last one of rotator cuff is this one. This is supraspinatus. Supraspinatus because it's on superior part of scapula. Easy enough, right? Function of this muscle is abduction. Abduction of shoulder joint. So these three are rotator cuff, teres minor, infraspinatus, and supraspinatus. What is the last one? I already talked about it. That's subscapularis, correct? Then last muscle from today's video, that's this one. This is triceps brachii. Triceps brachii. Again, this is for elbow joint, isn't it? Yes, that's correct. Part of triceps brachii attaches to scapula. You don't see it, but it's about this level. Important thing is it attaches to scapula. Thus, it can move shoulder. Main movement is shoulder extension. And slight adduction. Main movement is extension. Biceps and triceps can move shoulder joint. So, you should not ignore these two muscles for shoulder function. They are also important muscles. In today's video, I explained anatomy and function of shoulder muscles. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.